Welcome everyone to our YouTube channel Forensic Mart. Today we are here with another case study related to cyber forensic. The sexual harassment case. This case belongs to city Kolkata, state West Bengal, and the section of law apply in this case are section 419, section 501, section 507, section 509 of Indian Penal Code. And section 67 of Information Technology Act 2000. This case is the first registered cybercrime case in West Bengal. The background of this case is a lady launched a complaint that she was being harassed by a flood of telephone calls from unknown men with sexual intention at all odd hours and from various places around the world. As she was a working lady, most of the calls were received by her aged-in-laws. When she had her telephone number changed and requested the new number to be kept private, her neighbors started receiving the same kind of calls asking for her by name. This was thoroughly harassing her aged-in-laws, her husband, and also her neighbors. Some men also visited her house seeking her by name. The investigation of this case started when a caller ID was installed at the house of the complainant and a few of the local callers were interrogated. During interrogation, it was found that the callers had obtained her email ID in one of the chat rooms. All those who sent the mails to her got an auto response giving her residence telephone number and urging them to a call during office hour on working days, as her husband is away during those hours. On receiving such emails, these people contacted her on the phone numbers given in the email. After this, police requested for IP addresses of the email IDs from the website hosting company. In addition, they asked for IP logs and registration profiles of the respective email IDs. The logs revealed the service provider who subsequently provided the telephone number and the address of the user. The ISP provided the detail of the IP and addresses information connected to it. Raids were conducted at the residential address of the accused. It was found that on the two computer, temporary files of the accused had been deleted. However, using forensic software, few of these deleted files could be recreated. The PC of the accused also had incriminating evidence against him. He confessed to his guilt and was arrested. And during investigation, it was learned that the complainant was employed as a temporary executive engineer in the same company with the accused. The accused felt that though she was junior to him, she was not giving him proper respect. He started sending auto-generated emails in her name, giving her telephone numbers and asking males to contact her during office hours. Glossary. Charge sheet. The report of investigation to be submitted to the court by the police station, which present the conclusion of investigation and which precedes a formal trial and indictment. It is a formal charge of having committed a criminal offence. IT Act. An act in India to provide legal recognition for transaction carried out by means of electronic data interchange and other means of electronic communication, commonly referred as electronic commerce. Sub judice, a matter that is still under consideration by a court. ISP, Internet Service Provider. Examination, the crime scene examination and subsequent search. IP, short of Internet Protocol, it specifies the format of packets, also called datagrams, and the addressing scheme. Packet, a piece of a message transmitted over a packet switching network. Packet switching, refer to protocols in which messages are divided into packets before they are sent. Each packet is then transmitted individually and can even follow different routes to its destination. Once all the packets forming a message arrive at the destination, they are recompiled into an original message. Note: in internets, a processing location, a node can be a computer or some other device such as a printer. Log: to record an action, for example, to enter a record into a log file. Report of Class B: report of the investigating officer submitted to the concerned magistrate showing the case not being established under Section 173 of CRPC. Thank you for watching the video. For more such case studies, subscribe our channel and don't forget to click on the bell icon so that you don't miss our upcoming videos.